Hi, and welcome to our open stop-motion film project. I need the mic over here. I was a little late. I had to get something to eat. But now that is done with, and sorry. So here you can see the last episode. I was working on this little girl, and now I have her detailed, and she's ready to get scanned. So you can see she look much different than the other days. You know, when we start, they are a little rough, and then we start to get details and personality in them, and there's a lot of work to make one of these. But for those of you who haven't seen any other episodes, I will just touch what's the plan and how. See, but first we make these models, and when the model are made, we make a scan of it, and then we 3D print. You can see here I have an old man here. I have printed, and I of course have made a clay model of him too, to start off, and a hand like this. You can see the original hands here. Oop. First make the hand in clay, and then scanned it afterward. So, and that's the reason I make them so big as I do is that it's easier to make details. And then I print them out like this. This one haven't been, you know, you have to work on them after you have printed them, but this was just a trial. So, and then when you're out of this or a similar one, you then make a mold of it, and in that mold you make a silicon cast, and in that silicon cast you put kind of a skeleton or a thread or something that you can move the fingers and so on, so the you can animate that figure. So that's how sorry, take a little coffee, and then at last you have a whole figure you can animate and put in the forest we have made also. But you can always go to my site here, and you can under stop motion like this, you can page 1, 2, and 3, you can see all the episode before this, and you can also go into the blog, and where I have written some stuff about it, and you can see if you scroll down to the bottom, you down to the end of the site, you can see all the way to where we started making studio and hardware and stuff, all of that kind of, and we started making in pottery clay, and then we figured out that this wasn't working, and then I built a printer so we could print figures out, and you can see we have some of them here, and you can see this guy is there too in the original, and printed out there in another color, but the color doesn't matter. And here's the printer working. I built a box to it, so it made a lot of noise when we have episodes, so that we need. And then I made a toolbox, because I always run around and collect tools and can't find it and so on. And then this old compressor blew up the first time I tried it, after it has stood still for a lot of years. Then I started it and it blew up, and then I got this new one here, and the workshop where we by now have a lot of machines, small machines, and here we have started to cut the foam so we can make a landscape and a scenery. And Flint lives in this a cave here, and trees and butterflies and flowers and birds and people and bears and whatnot. And here you can see the picture of the scenery with all the trees on. But there's a lot of stuff yet to do before we get to move people around. We need to make, I hope next week I can go buy some iron to make start making a skeleton, or at least figure out how to do it. I of course have some ideas, but as with everything, we don't know if they work before you have tried it. I also still have to print a big Flint. Flint is the main character in the movie, so I'll make him in a big version first, and then I will try to make a bigger skeleton, and then see how small I can make it, because you can see the smaller it gets, that the tougher it gets to make the mechanics in it. So, but we will see. So there is a lot of work, so, but I have detailed this one, so she is ready to scan, and I don't know if I get scanning this weekend. I would like to, but I also have a trebuchet I have to do for the kids' workshop, so there's a lot to do all the times. But now we will take this little girl down and start to detail some of the other ones. So I will just get it and try not to destroy camera and so on. But you know, sorry, you could hear that in the mic. There are thousands and thousands of hours working in this, so we will not get finished any day soon. And then I decided he has to pick some ears. So you know, when you go and you have them standing around and you go and look at them and then you think, no, that's too much, and no, that's too little, and so on. Nothing wrong with big ears, but and we are not trying to make them hundred percent natural, because as you can see, I make this so they are little Neanderthal like, but in the Stone Age there wasn't any Neanderthal, so you know, I have, it's fiction, so you have a kind of freedom there. But I need to make a lot of persons, so I will push the mic a little while and then I will. So. That's why I'm jumping a little in the subjects, but the reason that I don't detail them at first is that exactly this reason that I can change them when I go and look at them and see that's wrong, and I can regret some of the things I did and make it different. Change a little here, there, and everywhere. I actually don't know. Sorry. I actually don't know how many of them I have made already, but I have made some already. I don't know, 10 or 20 or something like that. But we need a lot more. So it's just to get on with it. And sooner or later, you'll get there. Take some tools without hitting the mic. And the problem when you are printing a big print, then you have to be over the printer all the time, because otherwise it takes a long, long, long time. It takes at least 24 hours, and then last time I tried, then just before it finished, and I decided now nothing can go wrong, and I went to bed, and I shouldn't have done that, because right after that it stopped. The extruder stopped extrude plastic, so that was not a good thing, and you cannot start again. There are so many things in a print that can go wrong, so it's not so that you just can load the file and then leave the printer. We are not come to that yet. I will hope that we won't. Yeah, you can buy $100,000 printers. You can do that, but that's not an option here. We are trying to do the fun part and the special part with this project is that I'm trying to do it on a shoestring budget, and but somehow I keep putting a lot of money into it anyway. But still much cheaper than a Hollywood. Other places. Hollywood have a much shorter production time because they just throw a ton of people after it. I guess you all have seen at least the first minute of the credits after the film, and it goes on and on and on. I have seen it to end, and I know there are thousands of people in it, all different name. but until now there will only be my name on it, and that's not taking long to read. But when we are getting longer in the project, I will try to get some of the creative people I know on the net to help me with voices and music and that sort of thing. Music is one thing I can't. But we cannot send physical things around the world. That will be crazy. And I wanted to be everywhere where it's possible at all. I wanted to be physical stuff, not computer generated animation. Maybe something is going. Connection was. We have a problem now. I don't know what. I hate it. No, we are sending. Or are we? I don't dare click on it because then the wirecast will shut down. Everything seems to be okay. I hope. You can see I got a error message on the screen, but I can also see on a other monitor that we are sending. So we will not touch anything. We have dropped a lot of package. I think I have perhaps had problem all days with the net, but at least the recording will be okay, and then the stream is okay now, so we will not touch it. Because as soon as I check okay on that error message, it will shut the Wirecast down and we can start all over again. But at least the drop packets are not going up. Yes, I'm always ending there a little dry over. Right at the mouth, and the top is right at the eyes, so a little too. I'm afraid that my router is not good. It's just the net. Who knows? Computers and software can be a tricky thing. Earlier today, I couldn't send SMS messages. I think there's something wrong. System. But we also demand a lot of it. Well, at least I do. I think it was only a single glitch. The YouTube say that the stream is healthy. Believe them. Still too much here. Thank you.
Nope.
Too much one place and too little another. But that's how it is. So you can see it's a good idea if you make models like this that have a couple or three of them going at the same time, so you can leave some of them while you are working on another, and then come back after a while so you can go and look at them a couple of days or three. Because it takes a lot of hours and detail them when you have them like you want. The little lady I showed you as first, I have worked on all day. Just detailing. Not exactly all days, because I was kid from the school, so he has been here today, but it was only the time it took getting him that because he just get hold of a computer and then sits in the workshop and play Minecraft like all other 10 years old boys and girls, maybe also. He has started to play with his little sister, so maybe he will start on doing that too. Who knows? I'm trying to make the ears look similar on both sides. That's always a good idea. And the detailing I do now, I don't have to do on him later on. I have not done anything on him, but the better they are here, the easier is it with this one later. So, have to do it anyway, so. Why not try to do it here? And I know that's not so exciting to look at. But I myself love to see how people make stuff. That's maybe just me. Up, up. I remember as a kid, I bought a book about, I don't know, remember his name anymore, but was a Jewish sculpture. He was really good. But that was before Minecraft. So my father was a graphic designer like me, so I have grown up around stuff like this. Maybe that's the reason that I like it. I don't know. But I also loved electronics, but in my, that was, we built crystal radios and that sort of stuff. And when we was a little older, we built amplifiers too. To artificial stereo. It was not stereo, but kind of stereo. And at that time, television was over the airways, and that's some places still are. But at that time, it was for everybody. and it was and we here in this country we only have one station, the national TV and radio station. So but we lived where we could. If I built a amplifier, then we could antenna amplifier, then we could take first, we could when they started what are you calling it, UHF, then we could with an amplifier and a good antenna, then we could take Sweden. But you can only amplify to a certain level, because at a point you start to amplifying the noise to what you we call snow on the screen, and you got a lot of snow instead. So good days we could take Sweden. That sort of stuff. And of course, pictures to develop your own film and copies and that sort of stuff. That was kind of fun too. But I don't think kids nowadays are interested in that. He's not my grandkid, but they are not that old yet. But maybe it will come. But my own kid was not that interested either. But maybe I can cheat my grandson or granddaughter into a Raspberry Pi or something like that. My youngest son is into computers, programmer, what do you call that, coder. This guy have a tendency to not that I will strengthen you, but I need to see your face. It's oil I'm putting on. It's an oil-based clay, so I can get rid of all the dents. But they will all have a wig on. And then I have some birds in the freezer, or not the freezer, the fridge. And then I think also have some mushrooms, not the eatable ones, but those made in clay to the forest floor. And that sort of thing. I have a whole load to print. And then I, of course, have the old guy behind me here, another old guy, or old and old, but you know, we have them in old ages. Can I get around here? Out. I need to detail too. This guy. But I don't think you have the patience to watch all of that. So we will finish for tonight and then carry on. I will carry on the rest of the weekend till we come to, we have a tent here too, till we come to Monday night, and then I hope we will meet again for another episode of Yellow Clay or something else. I'll see if I can't figure out something else to do to a change. But now I have the weekend, and this time I have the whole weekend for myself, so I don't have birthday and that sort of thing, and that helps a lot. So I will say thank you for, if I could hit my mouse here, thank you for watching, and hope I will see you again on Monday. Goodbye.